All right, good morning. I promised that I would try to do a little bit of a more detailed coop tour. So we'll go and check out the coop and I can try to fill in some details and frequently asked questions. Basically, our little coop here is about 3x5. The minimum recommended space for any coop per bird is about 2 to 4 square foot per bird. So in this 3x5 foot space, we could probably keep about, I don't know, maybe up to 7 hens. We've had 6 in here and it's totally fine. But keeping in mind, the girls are only in here when they sleep for us because we don't have harsh winters, you know, it's not snowy. So if you have a place that is snowy and your girls need to be in there for longer, locked up for extended periods of time, you definitely want to give them ample space, you know, space for food and water. We don't have our food and water in here. That's in their run over here, which I'll get to in a second. All right, I'm backing up a second to talk a little bit about construction. Basically, we just designed this based on some different pictures I saw online, but also what we had around. We actually reused a bunch of random plywood and 2x4s that were left over on the property from the previous owners. So we just made do with what we had, and then we bought a new solid floor and a new solid roof. But otherwise, just tried to keep in mind, you know, the space that the girls would need, plenty of head clearance over their roof. So I think they have at least 2 feet over their roost here. You know, everything's locked up, so nothing can get in here, you know, with screening, hardware cloth over all the windows and vents. You want to have good air circulation in a coop, so we created a cross breeze by doing 2 across the sides. Depending on your climate too, that you want to take into consideration, not too much outdoor air, depending if you need to be able to kind of close them up well in the winter time. All right, and then inside here, this little panel lifts. Oh, I didn't want to make a huge mess, but basically that lifts so that when I need to fully clean out this huge door here is kind of like my human access door. They go in and out through that and a ramp into the run. But this is the door that I use to get in here, check in on them at night, and then I can lift this up and just put like a trash can or a bag or whatever right up to this and scoop out all of their bedding. We use the like shredded, what is it, pine shavings, and put a little bit of DE, diatomaceous earth, down inside the bedding, kind of below, not on top, so more like on the floor of the coop, because it can cause respiratory issues if it's like kicked up a lot and stuff. So it's mostly like under their poop board and deep in the bedding, just for... It'll kill, basically DE desiccates or kills like mites, or if you have any issues like that, it helps with pests. And so the roost, you always want to, at all possible, keep their roost above their nest boxes at a height higher. And so keeping their roost above their nest boxes encourages them to roost and sleep there because they naturally want to get as high as they can, so then they won't sleep in their nest boxes, and that will give you, you know, no poop in your nest boxes and cleaner eggs. So that helps discourage sleeping there. Another thing you can do when they're young is put dummy eggs, like they sell little dummy eggs or even like a golf ball is what we used, in their nest boxes to show them that's where eggs go, and that encourages them to lay there when they're first learning, and it keeps them from sleeping in there as often, especially if they have a roost. So we like to use a nice wide 2x4. It's just more comfy than a round dowel, so they can get situated in there. And then underneath, these are the poop boards. So basically, that's just thin plywood covered in a cheap laminate flooring material that we bought, and it's just glued on there, and it makes for really easy cleaning. So we can scoop this every single day with just a paint scraper and a dustpan into a bucket. All right, and then going around to their nest box side. And they're spoiled, so they have pretty little decor. Hey, Phoebe, can you come help show everybody? So there's their nest box. And basically this has a latch too, and I put a little chain here in case I need to, you know, prop it open and hook it open if I'm doing like, you know, cleaning and maintenance or whatever in here. But basically they have 2 nest boxes. The recommended size for these is at least 12x12x12, a little spot for them. And we keep on the bottom of ours, we buy these nest box pads. It's just this like kind of wood material, or I mean, you know, recycled fiber material here, and then we put some fresh straw on top of it, but that just makes it so when they're nesting they don't dig all the way down and lay their eggs on the hard plywood and then eventually, you know, possibly break them, and it makes it more comfy for them. So that's easy access back here for us to collect the eggs. All right, so a little bit more about their run here. Basically, what we have here is a totally enclosed, secure run for them, but they don't hang out in it all that much. They hang out kind of in the morning and in the evening in here. It's completely predator-proof, though, because we use hardware cloth instead of chicken wire. So hardware cloth is recommended instead of chicken wire as a good, you know, predator, vermin, rodent-proofing. A lot of animals can chew through and rip through chicken wire. It's also buried a foot deep and aproned out below there, so nothing can get into this run. That means that we can leave their little door here from their coop into the rest of their run open all the time, because they can come and go, you know, in the early morning when they wake up and stuff. And then they're let out into the yard with their solar powered door by pull it shut. It opens at about just after dawn and closes just after dusk, and it has a little battery and a solar pack, and then they can free range. So the little automatic door is a huge lifesaver and peace of mind for us. If we're out of town for a couple nights or out to dinner or something, then we know not only are they safe and locked up and secure in their run, but they can also enjoy their free range time even if we're not around, which is important for us because they're used to it and that's what they like. There was a time where we had to keep them locked up in their run while we were out of town for a few nights and they were not happy. It was a few years ago, but they started eating each other's butt feathers in protest, because I guess they were bored. So that leads me to talking about enclosed spaces like this. So if you have an enclosed run and you have daytime predators and so you can't let your chickens free range, definitely provide them ample space and, you know, entertainment, toys, you know, things to roost on. So we have an old tree right here that we cut down and reassembled in here. You know, roosts and mirrors. They actually like to look in the mirrors for entertainment. And the recommended minimum space for birds in an enclosed run like this is 10 square foot per bird. And so we could technically keep up to like 15 in ours, because this is a 30 foot long by 5 foot wide run. I don't think I would keep that many in here, but that's just me. Every flock is different. Some flocks don't mind to be, you know, and they're more used to being a little bit more confined, but definitely, you know, provide them treats and other ideas like a hanging basket. You've probably seen we have a hanging basket over on our tree. Jennifer's roosting over there. But if you keep like a hanging basket that you can put like cabbage in or different little treats, you know, that's something that'll help keep them occupied and happy. So yeah, 10 square foot per bird. And the flooring is washed concrete sand. So we had our native soil out here and it was really dusty and they would kick it up in like our bay windows over there and the dust was going everywhere. So we got washed concrete sand. It's almost like kitty litter, so it's easy to scoop their poop up and stuff. Hi, you gonna come demonstrate? Because what I was going to say next is about like biosecurity. So even though our girls free range and they're actually out in the yard most of the time, we do keep their food and their water. We keep one water in the yard too sometimes, but we keep food and water inside the run. And that way at night, again, that's also locked up and safe, so that rats and raccoons and possums and even other wild birds that potentially have any kind of disease won't be able to get in here or out to their food if it were in the yard, I mean, and potentially contaminate it. So it's sort of a biosecurity measure to keep the birds safe, keep them free of disease and parasites and viruses that other animals might be carrying. So keeping that locked up, if you don't have like a predator-proof run, are you gonna go lay an egg? If you don't have a predator-proof run, you know, try to put out fresh fruit every day, food every day, or, you know, keep it closed so that other animals can't get into it, because that's just a pest problem for you too.